controversy brewing over a new way to carpool. According to a report in the Washington Post, some parents are opting to skip the drive to school, counting on Uber to get their kids there before the bell by themselves. Like, they just stick them in. They're like, see ya. But not everyone is sold on Uber as the modern school bus. We're going to hash this out in a good old-fashioned debate. Susan Patton is the Princeton mom. She is here. She is author of Mary Smart, along with Matt Welch, who is the editor-in-chief of Reason Magazine. Thanks to both of you. Susan, what do you think of this idea? I mean, you put them in, you call the Uber, you put them in the Uber, or you say, Sally,
no.
See ya. No?
No, Melissa, you don't put your child in a car with a stranger and say, see ya later. No, that's irresponsible parenting. We certainly don't do that. This is part of what it means to be a parent. You get your kids up in the morning, you make sure they're dressed properly, their homework is done, and you get them to school. And why do they have to be in a car altogether? Why aren't they walking to school? We have an obesity epidemic among young people today. Maybe it'd be a good idea if they walked to school. Or if that's not a possibility, you walk to the bus.
Yeah.
Or you take the subway. But no, you don't put
I mean, the subway is safer? The bus is safer?
Of course it is.
I don't know about that.
I wouldn't say that.
Matt, what do you think?
I wouldn't say the bus is safer. I mean, I live in New York City.
Me too.
I'm not sure that the local bus drivers union getting the contracts here are the most safe source of drivers out there. And I don't know if you've ever seen kids on a school bus, but it's not exactly the safest way you could ever have.
Look, I understand that.
This is a question of choice. This is a question of choice. The wonderful thing about markets is that they give us choice of different ways to go. And one of the things that Uber and other ride-sharing services do, they allow us to assess people's level of trust, including your own. It does things that a cab company cannot, that a bus driver provided by the schools cannot. It tells us, is this person trustworthy? We have a new choice for people who want to put kids in cars.
So this is the argument. I mean, this is a modern society right now. I live in Manhattan. There is not a school bus that takes kids to school necessarily unless you go to one of the public schools in your neighborhood.
Right.
There are plenty of parents with very small children, even if they're not working moms.
I understand.
With small kids, you go out in the snow with the baby in order to schlep the other one care.
Yes, you do. You even wake the baby up from a nap and stick him in his stroller with his blankets and all his stuff to get to school, not only to get the older one to school on time, but you do it a second time to pick them up and bring them home.
I think that's the job of parenting. I think this is totally commendable. My hat's off to you. I walk my daughter to school every day. I think it's a nice thing for parents to do, but I don't think it's the only mode that we can say is acceptable in the modern society.
I think
there are other things to do.
There are so many ways of completely abandoning our responsibility as parents and sticking your kid in a car with a stranger. Is just one of them.
For the record, I put the kids in the back of my car. I drive them to school every morning. The idea of being able to send them like that is tempting. But my husband and I were talking about this. Can you imagine if something happened? I mean, it would have been your fault. You would never forgive yourself.
That's exactly
right. Thanks to both of you for coming on. We appreciate it. Thank you.